The reaction from Washington to that dispute last week was somewhat of a victory lap. This morning, I imagine, anything but.
No, it's not a victory lap, although we did hear from Jared Bernstein, the chair of the White House's Council on Economic Advisers, talking to CNBC. He said this is more about yellow and less about a market indicator for the economy. And he did repeat what the president likes to say a lot, Jonathan, and that's the fact that he says he's the most pro-union labor president in modern history. The optics, though, could be muddled for the president, given the fact that yellow reached out at the end of June to the president in a letter. And this is what the company had to say. Despite support from your administration, these efforts have proven unsuccessful at getting both sides to the table to discuss a way forward. The company blamed union intransigence, Jonathan, that Yellow's business plan has been frozen. There's another political aspect to this as well, Jonathan. It might not bode well for the former Trump administration, and Trump, you know himself, is a candidate and potential nominee for the 2024 election. Under his administration, Yellow got a $700 million loan on a national security designation that now Congress is saying Treasury and the Defense Department made missteps in that designation and giving that loan.
And Mike McKee, are we learning loads about yellow or a fair bit about the labor market? The more I read about yellow, the more I believe it might be the former and not the latter.
Well, I think you're right, John. Yellow does have some unique problems that led to its demise, although certainly the labor issue is a big one as people try to get their money back from the inflation of the last couple of years. But here's the good news for at least the U.S. economy. There are a lot of trucking jobs open, over 600,000, according to the last JOLTS report. We get another one on Wednesday. And if that's the case, then the 30,000 people who are losing their jobs should be able to get new jobs fairly easily. So this might fade as a political issue. The UPS strike would have been much worse had they not settled, because we were talking hundreds of thousands of people there. But the Yellow company is what they call a less than truckload company, where you don't have to fill the whole truck if you're a shipper. And there are a lot of others in that space. And the feeling is they can pick up the overall load, especially since less than truckload loads have started to go down. Yellow had gotten into a lot of debt problems because it bought a number of other companies, especially some that were unionized, and their wages were higher than the rest of the industry, and their overall costs were higher than the rest of the industry. And when the Teamsters came to them and said, it's time to give us a raise, it basically boils down to they didn't have the money.